We will make report together. My name is Michael Shevtsov. I am from St. Petersburg. And I worked in a holographic lab under leadership of Professor Denis Yuk, pioneer of holography, more than 25 years. So I want to start from the story, because the story of display holography started in Soviet Union after discovery of white light holography by Professor Denis Yuk. It's one beam scheme of recording, and the scheme was so simple. It's demonstrated here, so it's easy to record holograms of such type. And working in State Optical Institute, Denis Yuk developed high-resolution emulsion sensitized to red light, krypton, and helium neon lasers. And good lasers arrived to Russia from Spectrophysics company. Immediately, we started to record big-size holograms. We say big size, that means starting from 30 by 40, 60 by 80, and 80 by 1 meter 20. And many were organized immediately, many holographic expositions, mostly holograms of museum objects. And even in 1985, we demonstrated one exhibition here, holography treasures of the USSR in London. It was a very great exposition, and even we demonstrated many objects from different museums of USSR, from Kiev, Leningrad, Moscow, Minsk, etc. And we organized many exhibitions all over the world at that time. Next slide, please. This professor, Denis Yuk, worked on his first holograms. And finally, in 2005, when he visited our exhibition, he looked at his hologram made maybe 10 years ago. It's 1 meter 20, 80 centimeters, and said that when I invented the method of my method, I even didn't think that I will see sometimes this in reality, because at that time we had no lasers. But now I see it works. He was a very good man. And that time we thought that we will develop holography more and more, and we started to make holograms bigger, brighter, and pulse holograms, etc. But the problem was that sensitivity of materials we used, naturally it was materials, Russian materials, Soviet materials, and lasers usually used Soviet and optics Soviet. We were rather close country, but materials was high definition but low sensitive, and mostly sensitized to red light. So for museum applications, we needed to create the emulsion sensitized to all visible region of spectra. And so this work naturally started in State Optical Institute and in many other laboratories, and Hans Bilhagen did the same. And that time, in the beginning of 90s, next slide, please. We started our work together with Yves Jonté in his holographic studio in Bordeaux. And in 95, he visited our institute with Professor Denis Yuk. We discussed all problems, and he was very happy that that we started this work. And this work was rather hard and still didn't stop. And the results of that work is the creation of new color emulsion. We called it Ultimate Color Emulsion. Okay, as inventor of this emulsion, Yves Rontet will continue, but this is our first step, second step, and about the next steps, Yves will explain.
So I started to work on this emulsion in 92, and the meeting with Denis Yu was interesting because he encouraged me to continue. You have to understand that to make this color material, it was not a matter of millions of euros. Some companies or people try to get money to develop the same, and they think it's money. It was, in fact, more hard work, a laboratory work, because before to get the result that I demonstrated in 2000 in Austria with a clown, I made about 300 atoms. And every emulsion takes about 20 hours to be produced, and after, let's say, 30 hours to be tested, so 50 hours for one, and now I am at almost at number 400, so it means something like 20,000 hours of work, laboratory work on this material. So the main advantage of this material is the high sensitivity, comparing the former and even actual, because no improvement since 20 years, the sensitivity of my material is much more, about 20 times. It means instead to need millijoule, we need microjoule. So the final result is a design of the next, please, of a mobile system. So now you can see I copied Hans Belkagen drawing, but you saw his gigantic bench with very high power laser, and this is a new camera. The three lasers are inside. And this is my standard object, the clown, and we record with this box that we connect anywhere. In some seconds, we can shoot a 30 by 40 hologram. The exposure time now is about 15-20 seconds. And inside we have three red, green, blue laser, but each laser are not watt, but milliwatt. In fact, three laser, 25 milliwatt. And with this camera, we produce, this is another clown, not exactly the same. And you see after recording and processing, you can see the plate with the hologram displayed under the light of this box simultaneously with the real object. So now you can maybe run a video. Yes, I made a small video. Just reduce and... Yes, this one, yes. It's for advertising on the web. This is my material. You see, it's a block. You can cut many plates with this, totally transparent. And this is a video of one butterfly box, which is displayed here in the exhibition. Video is not so good, but you can see. What is an emulsion? You see, it's a fine layer of gelatin sensitized with nanograins of silver coated on a glass plate. This plate, now it's in white light, but usually it's in dark room, of course. You put this plate, transparent, over the object, and you illuminate with this box. The shoot is some seconds. And after processing, I cut the processing part. If you place the plate on the box, you can see the hologram simultaneously with the object, and here again. Identical to the original, but made of light only. You have an absolute double of the object. This is some insects I recording in the Natural History Museum in Bordeaux. And this is the clown, And this is not the video of the object itself, it's a video of the hologram. And for those who don't know the clown, I made one before coming. This is the clown. You see? The main difference between my material and other material is you can get color, saturated colors. You will compare with other color holograms. They always are pastel color. Because instead to capture a narrow band and have high efficiency like here, the result is not so impressive and you get noise and pastel color. Here you see the color are very sharp, very bright. And now I can show you another one. I did 1 week before coming with a mobile system. So these are not museum objects, but demonstrate the possibility of this box. Now we are talking with some museums for some projects. This is another object, you see. And you can see other different colors like pink. Voilà. I have many. I brought maybe 20 of them. So after the conference, if you want to see more, just ask. You can see this color is unusual in holography. And Hans was explaining the difficulty to capture all colors. It's true, it's difficult, but we can capture some of them, even with three lasers. Okay, this is for this new box for recording inside museum using Denis Hugh technique. Now, another technology.
Some words about the
next
technology we have in
next
studio.
Next.
It's okay.
This one.
Okay, because you know some problems with the objects, especially soft object, objects made of soft material or fragile object. So in this case, we use pulse lasers. We have portable cameras. Based on neodymium YAG laser, and even there is a sample how to record holograms transmission master in the conditions of
museum.
This is one experiment. You see, Yvon Tay makes hologram in the Aquitaine Museum in Bordeaux, and right in the middle there is a photograph of transmission master, size of transmission master 60 by 80, and make sure we can copy. And this technique is very practical, and even in the Soviet Union, next slide, we designed a small holographic camera, we say GRIF, green flash, the left side. You see the size of the camera, you can easily move this camera in any museum, any place, all over the world, and make your holograms of stuffed on or live objects. There is some samples of holograms we made. This is reflection copy. Naturally, when we make reflection copy, we can force objects to be projected out of holograms. It's very impressive holograms. And size is, I told you, up to 60 by 80. So
its
technology is available now.
Yes. So, but we'll just 1 second back. We'll not talk more about that because it's monochrome. And now, of course, when we have color, it's not so interesting to work with monochrome. But I just want to say that this mobile cameras work because on the last one on the right was done on Saint-Barthélemy Island. It's a French Caribbean island where I went. During 4 months, one winter, I didn't want to spend in Bordeaux, cold winter, so I decided to spend one winter on a Caribbean island, and I went with my mobile studio, And I stayed about 4 months, and I made 200 shots on the island. And this is one of the funny objects I recorded. I took iguanas, turtles, and animals I found on the island. Some people brought them to my studio, and I shooted the animals. But the goal on this island it was to shoot portraits of people. Okay, the next. So this is the latest technology available on the market. So computer generated images transferred to holographic material. So the idea was to develop a machine able to use this material. So comparing other companies having millions of dollars of budget, I was obliged to use a more restricted budget, but simultaneously trying to improve the technologies and the result that concurrents had done already. So I could analyze first what other people did and try to improve. So finally, my machine, which is a very strong machine, industrial machine, is, I would say, a second generation because it corrects the defects of the first images I saw over the world, like made by Geola or Zebra. So I have. So in this technology, we use the same three lasers, red, green, blue, and we print point after point an image on the material. So I designed the complete machine, the calculation program with a calculation center here, able to render the images. Show me the next, please. Okay, and I designed the holoprinter itself with an optical head using the red, green, blue laser, able to print ogle after ogle. You see on the right up the detail of every print, one after one. But when the machine was finished and I started to print on my material, the result was nothing at all. Because this material designed for continuous laser didn't work with pulse. And we wanted to make extremely short exposure time for each point, and the material didn't react very well. And furthermore, the color we used to print this holoprint were not the same color than with a mobile continuous laser system. So, for example, the red was not recorded. There was no red at all. So it took several months, even 1 year, to develop a new material specialized for this kind of printing. And this is some results. Maybe the next, there is Baudieu on the next slide. Show the next slide. Because I want to talk about museum application, and this is one first museum application we did with this machine. Is there on the next the scanner view or?
Yes, the next.
Show me. No, not. The next? There is no more next?
No.
Okay, back. Okay, this statue is a statue in Amiens Cathedral in France, and it's a wood statue, but colorless today, no color. But in the 13th century, these statues were painted. And scientists looked inside the wood and found very small particles of the old paintings. So they could, finding this dye, say how the statue was 600 or 700 years ago. So someone came in the cathedral and scanned fully the statue. And after, a graphic designer had what we call restored colors. It means the original color of the statue. And of course, they could not repaint the statue, which is still inside of the cathedral. So they asked us to print this 3D file in color. So they could display side by side the real statue and the color, recolorized statue. So let's, I show you one print. Mm-hmm. Okay, this is a printed so this is an holoprint, and
if you want to show
the movie, let's start the second movie, and it's finished after. After. Okay. There is a second movie that explains the holo camera, and yes.
Hmm?
Okay. This is the principle of the holo printer. Originally designed by MIT, so I just follow the track here. This is the Bourdieu, the file provided by the cathedral. This is the calculation center, and this is the control screens of the holo printer. And it was a full parallax image. This is the printed image before lamination. I kept it like that because you can see that it's a film, a holographic film. This is another application, another client. And this is the holoprint when it's laminated. And it's a test hologram to demonstrate the possibility of getting the color with the machine. Saturated and bright colors. So I have its big size, but I could carry only the small. This is the small. I don't know if you can see, but you can guess the saturated color of the work.
Lamp.
The lamp down. Up. After the conference, you can come and see it. You can see very, very bright and saturated color. So this material works so well that now we produce masters. It means this an hologram able to be mass reproduced. And we are very interesting now with the new coming of the photopolymer, because we know that we can reproduce on the photopolymer, for example, this kind of master in big quantities, keeping the same quality. So in fact, we have here a new mastering machine with a very well working material that offers new possibilities for the future. So we are open to talk with partners, and it's not true that my material is not for sale. My color material is not available. It is available, but I cannot sell one plate ready to produce this kind of hologram for 80 euros. But if someone wants to have a partnership with us, a museum project, an industrial project, they come to see me, and I did it already with several people and several groups all over the world, and we will work together, and I will propose what I have as technology, as material. We can work together. This is for future.
Okay.
It's finished.
Thank you very much.
Okay.